Gentlemen and ladies, I recently had a bit of a nostalgia trip. You see, when I was growing up, one of my favorite games was Canis Canem Edit, or Bully as most people know it as. Contrary to the title of the game, you don't actually bully anybody. You play as Jimmy Hopkins, a new student at Bulworth Academy. Jimmy's goal is to make the school a better place by helping people and trying to put a stop to the bullying. Yeah, I could spend hours talking about the bully lore, but I'll instead actually get to the point. In the game, you unlock the ability to use a skateboard. I recently replayed Bully and had a lot of fun using this skateboard. Of course, because I'm a veteran Stardew Valley athlete, I immediately thought about how a skateboard would be a great addition to Stardew Valley. Luckily, there is indeed a skateboard mod for the game. So, in this video, I will be doing anything and everything I can to craft and use this skateboard and become Jimmy Hopkins. So in order to craft the skateboard, we need 4 hardwood, 1 iridium bar, 1 iron bar, 1 refined quartz, and 10 sap. I start off with the easiest resource of these to gather, the sap. I annihilate some trees on my farm, then do some foraging in order to raise some money. Now, for some people, it may take a while to gather all of these resources. But we are not cavemen. We have technology, aka mods. So the first step is to head to Doran's Rest, where we can complete a quest to earn 1 dwarven ale, which sells for just under 2,000 gold. We meet Doran, who asks us to defeat slimes in order to gather 10 salt and deliver it to him. We also collect a hammer from a villager named Glorgan, and then set out on the first of what should be 2 quests. Should be. I made a slight error that kind of delayed the progress a little bit, but listen. We'll burn that bridge when we come to it. We collect all of the salt we need and deliver it to Durin, who rewards us with 25 dwarven barley seeds. The second quest we need to do is to plant the seeds and harvest the resulting crops, then give the barley to Durin. I return home and plant the barley seeds as well as my parsnip seeds and head to sleep. The next day I head to the secret woods because that's the easiest way to get hardwood. However, something disgusting happens to me. My axe isn't strong enough to break the tree stump, so we need 2,000 gold and 5 copper bars to upgrade our axe. Great, more work for us. I sleep through the next couple of days so I can get to the harvest day sooner, then head to the mines in order to get the copper and quartz I need. Luckily, we still have Glorgan's level 9 hammer, so this was a relatively easy task. I found an amethyst in the mines, and once I had gathered the copper ore and quartz, I left the mine and headed to Clint's, where I bought coal so I could unlock the furnace recipe. That was a long sentence, I don't know why I made that sentence so long. I also donated 1 of my 2 quartz to the museum in order to complete a quest and earn 250 gold. I finally harvest my dwarven barley and parsnips and delivered the barley to Durin. Remember when I said I made a mistake? Yeah, I did the wrong quest. The reward for this quest was 200 doubloons. The quest I actually needed to do for the dwarven ale was to walk into a shop in the village. That's it. That's literally all I had to do for it. With a heavy heart, and the utmost sadness coursing through my veins, I make my way to the shop where I complete the quest. I head back to Durin's and turn in the quest to receive my dwarven ale. I also make a discovery that causes every single dopamine receptor in my brain to light up. I don't know anything about science, so that might not have made any sense at all, but you get what I mean. I was happy. It turns out each doubloon is worth 5 gold. I have 200 of them. That's 1,000 gold on top of the 2,000 gold for the dwarven ale. I head home and toss a few items into my shipping bin. I head to sleep and I am met with a glorious sight. We made almost 4,000 gold today. That's some good progress. I head to Clint's where I buy 5 copper bars. I have the copper ore I need, but I was too lazy to buy coal, go back to my farm, and then put the copper ore into a furnace. I also buy the 1 iron bar I need and almost upgrade my pickaxe by accident. That would have been quite the scallywag move to make. I head home, get my axe from my chest, and go back to Clint's to get it upgraded. The only item we need now is the iridium bar. The problem is, it costs 5,000 gold. By the way, in vanilla Stardew, you can't buy copper, iron, or iridium bars as far as I know. But I have a mod installed that adds more items to the shops in Pelican Town. Speaking of mods, I also have a mod installed that skips the fishing minigame. I need money, and I'm desperate, so for the sake of not spending too much time trying to raise funds, I will use this mod to my advantage. Yeah, I forgot that I uninstalled that fishing mod, so fishing is completely out of the question now.
I am suffering.
Luckily, I have a backup plan, and that backup plan is foraging, specifically foraging in Durin's Rest. I spend a couple of days collecting salt from the slimes and gathering forage there to sell for gold. I collect my copper axe from Clint, then head to the secret woods in order to get the hardwood I need for the skateboard. I also find 2 morels and a slime Chuff's an amethyst. On the morning of day 11, I am just over 500 gold short of being able to afford the iridium bar. Thankfully, Robin pulls through and asks us to find her axe and return it to her in exchange for 250 gold. I also spot a dandelion hiding behind a tree on my farm. They call me the dandelion detector. Look, I used way too many nicknames during my last two or three Stardew Valley videos. I'm running out. Let's move on. I collect Robin's axe and sell some forage to Pierre. At this point, I haven't returned Robin's axe yet, but when I do, I will still be around 90 gold short of my target. I need a miracle to happen. And luckily for me, that's exactly what happens. I find not one, not two, not three, not five, but four daffodils near the community center. I planned that. I knew that they would be there. I love it when a plan comes together. Also, it turns out it was actually five daffodils. I give Robin her axe, sell the daffodils to Pierre, and finally have all of the gold I need. I literally cannot describe the excitement I felt when I bought the iridium bar from Clint. Finally, I can become Jimmy Hopkins, or a skater boy. I've realized now that I put skater boy in the title of this video, and at the start I said I want to become Jimmy Hopkins. It's kind of conflicting. I'm both, okay? I'm skater boy and I'm also Jimmy Hopkins. It doesn't matter. Also, you want to see how a veteran Stardew Valley athlete goes all the way from Clint's back to the farmhouse? First, we use the warp totem to get to Durin's Rest. Then we step into the warp circle. And that's it. Every single hair in my body stands up, my hands begin to shake, and I start to get pins and needles in my left foot as I finally craft the skateboard. It is done. The journey to become a skater boy is over. And what better way to celebrate this occasion than with a montage featuring one of the tastiest songs from the Bully soundtrack. So it turned out that the skateboard is a lot more difficult to control than I thought it would be. It kind of felt like I was wearing ice skates instead of using a skateboard. But I still had a tremendous time using the skateboard. In fact, I would even say that the vibes were immaculate during that. I also increased the farmer's speed by 10 to see if it would make the skateboard go even faster, but all it did was make the farmer's legs move really quickly. I think that about sums it up. I hope you enjoyed my journey to become a certified skater professional. As always, I'll have the mod linked in the description below if you want to try it out yourself. Have a good one.